Many of the best forehands in the history of this game have been hit by players using a semi-Western or Eastern grip. The palm of the hand and the base knuckle of the forefinger are lined over the side panel of the handle. The non-dominant hand plays an important role in the forehand. Besides drawing the racket back, it allows the hand to relax and it turns the shoulders. As the forward part of the stroke begins, the wrist is laid back. In these strokes, produced by Borg, Agassi, Nadal, and Del Potro, notice that the face of the racket is closed or turned down. For better timing, for more effective shot making, the arm is relaxed, the hand loose. The endless search for timing comes from a relaxed hand and a very still head. Keeping the head motionless and the eyes fixed to the point of contact betters the player's chances of making solid contact with the ball, producing a longer stroke, and hitting the ball with more depth. It also helps to keep the non-dominant hand down, more or less pointing at the net throughout the stroke. This helps with balance, coordination, get more solid center hits. It keeps the body quiet, helps prevent from lifting the head prematurely. Sometimes called the windshield wiper follow-through, the racket ends up across the body, below the shoulder. Certain shots on the forehand require a reverse follow-through. The racket ends up over the right shoulder. Contact away from and in front of the body. Here, open stance footwork allows Del Potro the spacing to swing freely. The slice forehand, used here as an approach shot, starts with the racket head above the ball. And finally, if the drop shot is part of your game, here's some inspiration from Chris Evert.